ओके, इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी सॉल्विंग दिस पजल और चैलेंज विच इज कॉल्ड डिजाइनर डोरमैट. सो लेट सी दैट. सो मिस्टर विंसेंट वर्क्स इन अ डोरमैट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनी. सो डोरमैट ही मेक्स एंड वन डे ही डिजाइंड अ न्यू डोरमैट विद द फॉलोइंग स्पेसिफिकेशन. सो वी हैव टू मेक अ डोरमैट विद दिस स्पेसिफिकेशन. ओके, सो मैट साइज विल बी एन क्रॉस एम. Okay, n rows and m columns. N has to be odd natural number and m will be 3 times of n. Okay, the designer should have welcome written in the center and design pattern should use these characters. Okay, this dash or whatever I'll call it. What should I call? Line I will call. I don't know the exact name. Then there is dot and there is dash. Okay, so sample design you can see here for a 7x21. Here you can see n value is 7, which is a natural odd number, and 21 is m, which is 3 times of n. Okay, 3 times of 7 is 21. So this is m, this is n, and we can see this is the design. So in rows, if you will see, there are 7 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and there are 21 columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Okay, so that's how it is making it 7x21, and in the center you have welcome. So they have used these characters only, n cross m and welcome. Okay, so this is what we have to make. There is another sample design which is slightly bigger. So here you can see it is 11x33. So n is 11, which is natural odd number, and m is 33, which is 3 times of n. Okay, so here you can see there will be 11 rows and 33 columns. Okay, and you can see in the center it is written welcome. So your code should be generic. Okay, so for any value of n cross m, means like given this condition. So that's how we have to make the code. Now constraints are given: n has to be between 5 and 101, and m has to be between 15 and 303, and input will be given as n space m. Okay, there will be space separated, so we can use split. Okay, so here you can see sample input 9x27. So it is 9x27. This is how input will be given. We will split it and we will make this kind of pattern. Okay, so one more thing here, you can see we are not given any code. So previously what used to happen is there was some code given to us and we just used to add some our code, that's all. But here this time you are not given with anything, so from scratch you have to write. Okay, so let's do something. Let's start. So first I'll take the input. So the input is given, you can see, in 927. So if I'll use something like this, n comma m equal to raw input dot split with space, so I don't put anything inside. Now if I'll print n and I'll print m, let's see we are able to extract them or not. So n and m we are getting together here, and we are saving it, and I'm splitting it and with a space here inside this. I've not given anything. This means it will split the string with a space, and it will save it to n and m. Okay, that's what it should happen. Built-in function or another object has no attribute. Oh, okay. So raw input should be like this, right? Yeah. So we are getting 7 and 21. So but the problem is, you can see here, you can't use these m and m. Okay, why? Because let's see, 4 for loop if I'll play I in range 0 to n. If I'll do it and I'll print I should not be able to use it. See, because we are providing an argument which is string. This guy is, it looks integer, but it is not. You can see it is written str. Here you can go and bring your cursor and don't click anything. It will say n is str. It's an string type of variable. Okay, and string type of variable you are giving here. So as an integer here you are treating. So that's why it is not able to use. So what you have to do is you change it to its integer, its type to integer. Okay, that's all. And save it to n only. Now it will become integer type. Okay, similarly you can do for m as well, so that you can use this m and m. Now you can use this thing, you will see, because I have converted n value of n into integer. You can see it is able to print all the values from 0 to 6. So means n value is 7 and m value is 21. So this is just to show you that how I will extract the input. Okay, so now I have the value of n and m. So what will be the logic I will try to implement is, see, it took me a lot of time to actually come up with some logic which I can print. I know that you won't be able to, some of you won't be able to completely, you will have no idea how you wanna approach this problem, right? It is different than what we were doing till now. So here you can see what I came up with. You can come up with some better logic. I'm just showing you what I have done. So there are total 7 lines. Okay, so what I did is I calculated the value 7 divided by 2. 7 divided by 2 will give you 3.5 floor value I took. Okay, you might be aware of ceiling and floor. Ceil and floor in Python. Okay, so that you will get a better feel. So it will just take the floor value or ceil value. Okay, just as an example, okay, here you can see a positive value, let's say this guy. So what I am doing is I am importing a module called math to calculate the value, and I am calling a method called floor. Okay, what floor will do is it will go to the upper value of this guy. Upper value is what? Sorry, floor value of this guy, because floor means compare it with your room floor. Okay, it is down, so 300 will be the value, and it will be a float value. Okay, it won't give the output in integer. Similarly, you have this value, you can see 300.72, and you are applying floor means down, so 300 will be the lower value. Okay, and it will pass the integer value, but it converted into float. Okay, similarly ceiling, if you will see ceil, this is ceiling, just like your room ceiling, you can say. Okay, so here you can see that if you pass 300.16 and you will apply ceiling, you will get 301. Okay, just upper value, integer value, but converted into float. This dot zero, you can see it is float value, so it's by default it gives output in float. That's why you have 301.0 instead of 301. So you have to convert into integer later on. Okay, so this is how the ceiling and floor works. That's all. Okay, similarly you can calculate for negative values. Now negative values, it will be different, right? Ceiling value will be -23. In negative direction you are going, so ceiling value will be -23 for -23.11, because -23.11 is smaller than -23. Okay, similarly here also floor you can see -23.11, so less value will be -24. Okay, so that's what I'll use here. So I'll calculate the whatever the last value 7 is. 7 divided by 2 is 3.5, and if I'll calculate the floor of that, I will get 3. Okay, so till 1, 2, 3 I will make this guy, and in fourth I will do this guy, and similar structure, this thing I will invert it in this direction. Okay, it might sound difficult, but once you will see the code, you will really like it. I mean, I enjoyed doing it. I mean, it took me one day, to be frank, to come up with some logic. Okay, now this is how I'll approach. First I'll do these guys separately, this guy separately, and then this guy separately, these three. So I've divided my code into three parts. Okay, first part is above welcome, second part is welcome, third part is below welcome. Okay, that's how I'll work. That's the frame. Now how you gonna do this thing, right? I mean, it might sound like you have to write each and everything here, but there is a nice way of doing it. Let me show you. If I'll print, let's say let's take this only, this structure, this. Okay, I'll copy it, I'll put here, this is my string dot center. I'll put the width, you can see that it is coming width and fill byte. Okay, so width is my, let's say 24, and I'll put the fill byte as dash. If I'll run this, see, I am getting this. Okay, so what this means is you have this string, you will print this string. See, this string, this is a string which is dot, line, and dot. Print this, keep it in center, total width will be 24, and rest of them will be filled with dash. Okay, so this total width is 24, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this till 24. Print this guy in the center, and rest of the spaces will be filled with dashes. See how many information it is having. There are a lot of information having in this one line only. So rest of the places will be filled by dash, 24 will be the total width. What has to be center? This guy has to be center, and I'm just printing it. This is a very small way. You can also look at like this, m equal to, like this I, you can write, and then m is equal to m dot, not m, some m is already declared here, so new something I write. Okay, new. Okay, so center, and then you can print new, and that is also a way. So this is a more easier way to see, but the more better way to use the previous one which I showed you. Okay, so I hope you are able to see that. You can also print in the left or right as well. So let me take L just, I think it is L just, yeah, L just. Okay, so it will be in left, L means left. So you can see this structure, whatever the string is, it's in left, this guy, this whole thing, because I applied L just. And total width is again 24, and rest of the places we are filled with dash. You can also do right, I think, or just, I don't know the syntax, or just, yeah, or just. So it will be completely in the right side. Okay, so you might be able to see how I'm gonna generate this. Similarly, you can generate this guy as well. So instead of writing this string, you write welcome, and you do it R, just center, so you don't have to do R or something. So you can see that I'm able to generate this welcome string. Okay, easy, one line of code. So I hope you are able to see that how I'm gonna make these patterns. Now I'm gonna use the for loop for this guy. This is already being made, this string. You can see that this is how I'll make. Okay, and then the last thing, now see how I will go. So first thing what we have to do is, here the width has to be m, right? M is the our width. Here you can see 27 is m, m is our width. Okay, this is our first thing. This is the center guy. Okay, and now what I'll do is I'll use a for loop I in range. I'll start with a 0. I'll do math dot floor, and math dot floor what value, n by 2. Okay, and I'll print I, let's say. Now what will happen, see, I told you, oh, okay, math has not been defined, so import math. If I'll run the code now, you can see that the your math floor should be integer, but the argument we are getting is float. I told you here you will get in float. So range doesn't work with float, it has to be integer. So I'll use integer. Okay, now I can use the value of n. See that 0, 1, 2. Now I have to make print the line. Okay, you can see that there is a common pattern. In first line you have this pattern one time, in second line you have this pattern three times, in third line you have this pattern 5 times, means odd multiples we have. So there is a slight trick I would show you. Okay, but first let me do this thing. Okay, I'll explain the concept here. See this string. Now let me print it 2 times. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll put star 2. See what will happen. My welcome has been printed 2 times. Now let's say I want this welcome only to be printed by 2 times, not the whole string. Then what will I do is I'll remove this thing from here and I'll put it here. So welcome will be printed 2 times and I'll put a bracket. Okay, like this. Now see the difference. See, welcome has been printed 2 times and rest of the string is as it is. Okay, so you can also do 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, like this, but I don't think it will be accommodated because with this, yeah, you can see. Okay, welcome, welcome, and it has exceeded the width, that's why you don't have dash. Let me exceed the width as well. Let's do 89. Some value, any value you can use, just to show you guys how things work. You can see 5 times it has printed this guy and rest of the spaces were covered by dash. Okay, so this is what I'll use. I'll go back. Welcome I don't want. So what I'll do is I'll print my string, this thing. Let me take this guy. Okay, this I have to print, but not this thing. I have to put dot line dot. This I have to print, And what I have to do is, I have to print this guy odd multiples of I, okay? Odd number of times, right? And how you represent odd numbers? 2i plus 1, right? 2 into I plus 1. This is the odd multiple, right? If I value will be 0, this whole term will be 1, right? If I value will be 1, this whole term will be 3. And if I value will be 2, this whole term will be 5, right? Let's see. Okay, str object is not callable. Okay, multiplication, I have not done it here. Yeah, so you can see that one time, 1, 2, this is 2 and this is 3. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. Total 5. Now I am done with above part. This code, this part is being generated by these guys, and the welcome is generated by this guy, which is outside for loop. Okay, so hope you are able to see that how I worked. Beautiful it is. Just as one for loop, and I was able to generate the upper part. Then this is the center part, and let me do the last part, which is reverse of this. So what I'll do is, I'll use the same for loop, but now I have to start with this value. Okay, so I'll do comma 0, I'll remove from here, and I'll run the loop in decrement way. Okay, so minus 1 is my step size, so each time it is decrementing. So what I'll start with is, you can see this value is what, 3.5 floor means 3. So 3, 2, 1, it will go till 3, it will start from 3, then it will go to 2 because the decrement is minus 1, then minus 1, 2 to 1, then 1 to 0 it will not go because the range works from 0 to whatever value we are going, 1 less. Okay, so let me see how it looks. Okay, so it is not exactly what we wanted. So here what is the problem is, this value is 3 at first. 3, if you will put 3 here, 3 into 2 is 6 plus 1, 7. So 7 you are getting here. Okay, which is what we don't want. We want 5. So what I'll do is, so it has to be 5, right? It has to be 5. So if I'll put 3 here, 3 into 2 is 6. If I'll do this minus 1, then see how it will work. If this will be 3, this will be 6 minus 1, 5. If this will be 2, this will be 2 into 2, 4 minus 1 is 3. And if this will be 1, this is 2 into 1 minus 1. Okay, so 1. You will get. So it is decrementing, it is working in reverse order, same code but just played with some mathematically. I have played and I am getting the same result. See that our sample test case is pass. So I know this looks a bit simple, but believe me, I had to come up with this logic. It took me more than one day. I was not able to generate these strings. I had to search about this method. You can do center, or initially I was just typing it from the initial to beginning, like dash dash dash, then dot, line dot, then dash. That's how I was doing. Then I realized there is a method called center you can do, and directly with one line you can make this kind of string. Okay, and just with some mathematics I played and I was able to generate this guy and this guy. The most easiest code is this guy, to be frank. Okay, so what we have done is, we have included one module, which is math module, and I'm using my value of n like this, and I am running the loop so that I'll get first three lines. Then fourth line I am getting like this, and last three lines I am getting like this. Okay, just a slight change I did here, and I have run the loop in decrement form. Okay, here one more thing that you have to convert into integers, because these are string and floats. That's what you have to remember. So we have wrote the code from scratch. What I'll do is one more thing, I'll add the constraint. So 52101. So I'll write if n is less than or equal to 5 or n is greater than equal to 105, then print what? Print n is out of range. Okay, similarly we can do it for m. M here also, m, and here also it is m. Okay, and 15 to 303 15, and this is 303. Okay, let me run this. Although it is not required, but still they won't check the constraint. One more thing we have to take into account is this has to be three times of m, has to be three times of n, right? So let me do another constraint here. Here I'll write what if how I should write, n is not equal to equal to 3 times of m. 3 times of m. If this condition is not equal to, okay, then m is, let's write, n is, let me write m is not equal to 3 times of n. This also is not required, but still for completeness sake you should be doing this. Okay, so what it will do is it will check whether n is not equal to 3m. If this condition satisfied, it will write m is not equal to 3n. Okay, so it will consider the case where if you will put m is equal to 9 and you will put some m is equal to some 21 or 23, then it will not work basically. Okay, so we are able to produce this, and you can see that for it will work for any value of n and m. Okay, there should be one more thing we can do, one more constraint we can add. N has to be odd, right? Sorry, Ctrl Z. N has to be odd natural number. So what I'll do is I'll put another constraint. N is not odd natural number, odd natural number. Okay, n is not equal to, I'll let me write the condition as like this, not equal to 0 or n modulo, I have to write right, n modulo 2 is not equal to 0. Equal to 0, that's what I have to do. So if this condition satisfied, means it is even number, and if it is even number, it will write n is not odd natural number. Okay, so that will cover the case of this n is an odd natural number. So it will check whether it is even or not. If it is even, it will print n is not odd. Okay, so it has to be odd number, and then there is constraint of m is equal to 3n, and rest of the things are taken care. Here we have considered this cases as constraints as well. So you can run the code. M is not equal to 3n. Not equal to 3n. Oh, sorry, I've done it wrong. M is not equal to 3n, and it should break, right? I mean, it should not go beyond it should not go beyond this line. So what we should do is else if we can put else if, and else if, and here also else if, and here I'll put else. Okay, and this whole thing I'll take shift tab. Oh, sorry, I'll control C tab. So it will come under else part. Let me run it again. Yeah, okay. So each of every case we have taken care of. Let's check the other test cases. Submit it. All the test cases are passed. Okay, so hopefully you have enjoyed this challenge. It is a really nice challenge, I would say. Took me time to be frank, and hopefully you also liked it. The logic also, you can build your own logic. I mean, I'm not telling you to copy the same logic as I have done it. Maybe my logic will be using two for loops. You can come up with something, one for loop only. Okay, that will be better, more better. I mean, fantastic it would be. Or if you come up with something, some logic which where you don't use math module, that also is fine. So I think, I hope you I am able to teach you something from this example. So let's go to the next challenge. Okay.